Oi boys, welcome back to another episode in our Penrith Panthers career mode series. As per usual, if you're watching us right now, be sure to hit up that comment section with the hashtag odd squad and hit that like button, as it does help support the channel. But yeah, in today's game we are going up against the Newcastle Knights. This will be our second meeting. We did play them way back in round 4, and yeah, that match was a forgettable one. We lost 22 points to 12, and it was Kalen Ponga that pretty much single-handedly carved us up. And yeah, we're out for blood this time around. We're looking to give them some of that treatment they gave us in round 4. Back on the second, as Api Korisau looks for Cleary. We try and clear it, play it safe. It is pretty wet. We fall short of the 40-20. We still find the line in a decent kick for our first set here. I may look for kicks more often in this match. See if we can play some realistic wet weather footy, as the Knights with the feed. Kalen Ponga breaks out of one. Or gets around one, breaks out of another. Man, Kalen Ponga was pretty much the hero of the Knights the last time we played, as they cough it up. Ooh, that's a tough error inside their own 40. They hand it over as Fisher Harris tests that defense. Cleary out the back, cutout ball, Edwards through the gap, looking to get around Ponga, but we get wrapped up from behind. Now we still got two tackles to work with, as Luai, that's a beautiful ball from Jerome Luai. The source, Mansour, gets us on the board. First up, first try scorer. From the sideline, Nathan Cleary looking to swing it back around, and it's a beautiful kick. Great start to the match. So we make the Knights pay for their poor passing within their own 40. Can we go back to back here? That's Api Korisau. Calls the play, sends it to Luai, looking for the line. Another early kick, and this time it's perfect. Ooh, zero tackle, we'll take that. Surely points on way. Ooh, as Crichton gets close. A little death short ball. Well read by the Knights. Edwards swings it wide, Liam Martin on the edge gets shut down and driven backwards. As Api finds Cleary, looking for Terevano, trying to crash over. Third, surely we can score here. Ooh, nice hit there on Fisher Harris. As Luai takes control and he just drops it under. A beautiful ball for the towering Fijian. Take a look at this. Maybe a hint of obstruction there? I don't know. You'd be the judge of that, but Velikikau doesn't even have to use his big body in that one. Just simply dove over the line, as easy as it gets. Half time. The Knights have absolutely nothing in this game. They look like a completely different team since the last time we met, as we take a look at the stats here. And take a look at that. 75% possession, 7 from 7 sets with no errors. That's near perfect. One thing I'm absolutely loving with the increased minutes is the fluctuation of points week in, week out, as the Knights make yet another error on the kickoff. And they frustrated. I think that Saifidi hits Leota. As we get wrapped up, 12 out, 3 tackles remaining. Or 2 tackles remaining, I should say. We look for a little inside ball. A little cross play to Liam Martin, but they've been all over Martin this game. As we go wide, we get Toa one-on-one, and they do well to hold him out. Fifth and last, can we make something of this Newcastle error? Or will it be a wasted set? Well, there you go. A wasted is. Second for the Knights. Another interception. Oh, Jerome Luai this time. What are the Knights doing? As we go wide to Fisher Harris, we're pretty heavy with our right side this game as they give away a penalty. Man, this is a I know I've said it numerous times already, but this is a terrible game for the Knights. Legend difficulty, by the way. Definitely a strange one here as we go to Luai. Trying to get Crichton through. That pass has worked time and time again, but there's no way through on that occasion. As Moses Leota running out to the sideline, trying to drop it back under for Mansour. As Spencer Lee Newell takes a hit up for zero gains. I feel like at this point we should be up by at least 20 points, but our attack has been a little dodgy. As we go to Cleary on the last, he just drops it behind the line, a little chip over the top, regather, and Cleary gets our third try of the match. Man, this is disappointing. Disappointing for the Knights. As we approach the final 10 minutes, Heimel Hunt, little break. He's wrapped up just before our 40 as Ponga. Haven't seen much of him this game. He's been well looked after that, and they've had barely any ball. As Shibasaki, cuts back on the inside to get away from Edwards. He scores the Knights' first try of the match. Coming 70 minutes into the game. Little bit of a consolation, I'd say, as Ponga converts. Knights 6, Panthers 18. If the Knights are any hope, they'd have to score in the set, as Saifidi gets wrapped up just before their 20. Running onto it is Sione Matautia, who is Super League bound, I believe. Believe that the Knights let him go. As Ponga, there he goes. Breaks one tackle, Dylan Edwards, with a bit of a try-saving ankle tap. On the third, Clemmer, look at the Knights, now they turn it up. Surely it's a little too late. As the clock continues to wind down, they go left. And Kurt Mann, 15 out, fifth and last. They go to Bradman, best, puts up the bomb, and the source as safe as houses. That's all we love to see from the classy veteran in Mansour. Dylan Edwards with ball in hand. Goes in a little run. Still 4 minutes remaining. We go to Cleary. And we're just slowing things down, taking hit ups. Wind that clock down. As we go to Luai. Tries to find Kikau, who's had a pretty quiet game. I was saying earlier that I was trying to get that right side involved more. Oof, Dylan Edwards lined up and knocked down. Cleary looking to clear it. And the tackle can't get to reset. That should be the game. We'll be able to run this one out here. As Cleary finds space around the middle of the ruck. This could be the cherry on top here. We send it. I tried to get the source a double. Seconds remaining. Little crossfield bomb just for the lulls. As Kalen Ponga makes the catch, but that's the game. Full time. A bizarre game, a bizarre performance from the Newcastle Knights on the hardest difficulty. That first 60 minutes from the Knights is probably the worst you'll see. Once we hit the 70th minute for some reason, and they tried to switch it on, but it was too little too late. As we take a look at the full-time stats here, look at that, 31% possession, 5 from 10 sets completed, and 7 errors. Nathan Cleary picks up man of the match, but as always, if you want to see more Rugby League Life 4 content, or more content in general, be sure to run it straight at that like button. Thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you. Later. Loyalty over everything, that's my team. From the bottom where we grinding, that's my team. To the top where we shining, that's my team.